Hey Ange, it's me. Okay, so I'm experimenting again, as usual. So I've been trying to get a good yellow gray. This is the best one, and I still really don't like it that much. So I'm gonna try again, but I'm not gonna do gray. I'm just gonna do yellow and white. So today, and I know people don't measure, but I feel like I need to measure. So I'm gonna measure my paints. And today I'm doing Floetrol because I want cells. So I'm using 0.3 ounces of paint. And then 0.9 ounces of Floetrol. So I should end up with 1.2 ounces of each color. Or maybe a little bit more. Floetrol's heavy, it's a new gallon. So this one is Artist Loft Brilliant Yellow. Come on, baby. Can't see my face. I'm sticking my tongue out while I stir. It gets chunky sometimes. It's so weird. And I'm gonna try making my paints thinner because the last one I did, I didn't get good cells, and I think maybe, I don't know why, maybe my paint was too thick. So I'm gonna try make it a little thinner this time. So one thing I really liked with the Floetrol glue blend was I had it dialed in pretty good that I didn't really need to add water, but I wasn't getting like the big giant cells that I like. Okay, this one, so I got four different yellows. This one is Liquitex Cadmium Yellow Light. Expecting a shipment of more paints from Joann's yesterday, but it didn't get here. Oh my god. Ooh, right on the money. Okay. So, going with what I got. I feel like the Liquitex mixes up easier than the Artist Loft. It doesn't get that weird chunkiness. A little bit more water. Okay. And then this one is Deco Art Americana Bright Yellow. Come on, baby. All right, good. Just enough. And this one I'm going to do a little less than 3:1 because I feel like this paint is more liquidier. So I still did 0.3 ounce of the yellow, and then I only added it up to like 1. So I have exactly 1 ounce of paint. This one doesn't really need any water, I don't think. And what this is, Cadmium Yellow Americana as well. I don't love this color, it's kind of like a little bit weirdly orangish to me. It's kind of like butter. Okay, and then I have my plain white. And then I'm also gonna mix up some pearl. This is the DecoArt Extreme Sheen Metallic Pearl. I really love this color. And then this one I did a little less than 3:1 as well. Pouring over, you can probably see it was one of my very first Fiona flowers, and at the time I'm like, this is awesome, and then now that I look at it and I'm like, that sucks. So I probably should have sanded the canvas a little, but I'm lazy, so I didn't. So I just gessoed over it with black gesso, and yeah, we'll see what happens. So, again, you know me, I'm not much of a planner, so this needs a little water. I'm gonna kinda go with the flow on this one, literally. I think I might do a swipe or something. Maybe that's my problem, is that I don't actually know what I want to do until I sit down, and then I'm like, how do I want to do this? I don't know. Well, let's try this or that. Okay, and then I'm gonna add my silicone, and I know they say don't add silicone to your white, but I don't know why they say don't add silicone to your white. So guess what, I'm gonna add some silicone to my white because that's the kind of rebel I am. I want everything to be super bubbly. Okay. I'm trying not to stir too much because I don't want to, do what I shouldn't, whatever. So I think I'm gonna just do some diagonal stripes, and yeah, we'll see what happens. It still might be too thick. I don't know. I do think it is now that I'm laying it out, but whatever. At this point, for me, it's all a guessing game of what works. What might work and what might not work. or this side of the canvas always gets the mostly empty cup. Oh, I forgot I still have more pearl. Maybe I'll just drizzle that in some of the Now I get to this point and I'm like, oh crap, now what do I do? See, this is where I always get lost. Look weird if I swiped this way, if it's at an angle, or should I swipe this way to keep the angle going? I don't really know. So I'll just keep pouring some white on the sides while I sit and figure that part out. This way I have options. Paint. And I'm a terrible planner, so that really doesn't go very well together. And it kind of looks cool just like this. All right, decision time. What would Andrea do? I don't know. Oops. I can see the silicone sitting at the top. Or should I just leave it like this and let it just flow? Okay, I guess I'll try a swipe. I guess I can always double swipe if I don't like it. But I'm going to do it at an angle. So I can keep my angle pattern going. And then I'm going to swipe it back the other way. It's a double swipe. I can just see there's like a ton of paint still piled on the canvas in the middle that I need to just pull off. This way. It almost looks like a candy corn. It's that one yellow, that regular cadmium yellow plain that I don't really love. Okay. There's a part over here that it's just not really adhering to the gesso very well. Although it's kind of looking kind of cool now that it's a little bit running together at that angle. This is the hard part. Like, on a lot of the videos I've watched, it's like, choo choo choo, 2 seconds. So that's what makes me think that maybe sometimes my paint is too thick. Or maybe on the YouTube videos, they just edit out the long, boring part where you sit and wait for your paint to run. I'm not sure. Oh, I forgot to wear gloves. Dang it. Okay, I gotta go wash my hands and then I'll try and fix the corners. I should run some black through, like with a comb. Ow. Okay, maybe my torch is running out of juice. It feels like it's not that hot. Probably need to refill it. My torch is out of juice, so I'll torch it and then I'll take a picture and send it to you later. But okay. Later, Gator.